Hi everyone, welcome back. Do you want to customize the view autocomplete component? Then you must watch this video to learn how easily you can customize the autocomplete component using built-in templates option in the view autocomplete of Synfusion. The autocomplete supports several options to customize each list items, group title, header, and footer elements. Look at this online example. You can see the autocomplete suggestion list showing web platform name and image based on my typed in characters. Here, each list item is split into two columns to display web platform name and image. Also, you can see the autocomplete suggestion list shows customized header and footer. Okay, now I will proceed to show you the code snippet to achieve this customization using my existing Getting Started application. Let me open my existing Getting Started application where I have added the view autocomplete with remote data. If you want to know how to create a simple view autocomplete, then you can listen to my Getting Started video, the link for which is shown in the above YouTube card. Also, you can download this existing Getting Started example from the GitHub link which I have shared in the description part below. Here, to have better clarity, I am replacing the remote data with JSON data collection which contains an array of objects with two fields, namely name and ID. Also, I have mapped name field to value property. I have assigned web platform names to data source. So, let me change the placeholder property value as select a platform. Also, ensure whether these data item and data fields variables are assigned to the data source and fields property of the autocomplete. So here, you can see the autocomplete showing web platform names. Now, I will show you how to add images for autocomplete items. To customize autocomplete items, within the data function, first I need to define a variable autocomplete item template. Now, I will start to define the template. Here, I have planned to display web platform name and image in autocomplete items. So, let me define div and span elements. To add web platform image, I need to modify the existing data source by adding one more field image with appropriate values. Then, I will assign this newly defined data source field image to class attribute, as I am going to use background image attribute to add image to span element. Also, I need to assign name field to another span element to add web platform name. Now, let me assign this variable autocomplete item template to item template property of autocomplete. Also, I have defined few CSS styles for this item template. So now, you can see the autocomplete component showing web platform names and images. Next, let me proceed to show you how to add header for the autocomplete suggestion list. For that, within the data function, first I need to define a variable autocomplete header template. Now, I will start to define the template. Here, I am planning to display photo and platform as header in autocomplete suggestion list. So, let me define span elements with the text, photo and platform. Now, I need to assign this variable autocomplete header template to header template property of autocomplete component. Also, I have defined few CSS styles for this header template. And now, you can see the autocomplete component where the suggestion list is displayed with the text, photo and platform as header. In case, if you would like to show the total list items count at the bottom of the suggestion list, then you can make use of footer template property. Now, let me customize the autocomplete footer and display the count of suggestion list items to it. For that, I need to define the footer template property of autocomplete. First, let me define a variable autocomplete footer template within data method and assign an empty span element. And I will give a class name as footer for span element. I will assign this variable autocomplete footer template to footer template property. Here, I'm going to display the total number of items present in the suggestion list to this footer element of autocomplete. So, let's see how to do that. I will define the views built-in mountain method, and within that method, I will wire the keyup event for autocomplete element. And I will also make a call to a method onOpen within which I am going to write a logic to get the total number of items displayed in the suggestion list. Therefore, within this onOpen method, I will use this public method getItems of autocomplete. To access this getItems method, I need to create a reference for autocomplete by defining ref attribute on autocomplete code. This getItems method will retrieve the current items displayed on the suggestion list, and then I will assign the total count of these items to the inner HTML of footer template element. Also, I have defined few CSS styles for this footer template. So here, look at the autocomplete component where the suggestion list is displayed with the text total list items to at the bottom of the suggestion list. Finally, I will show you how to group the data items using group template property. Here, to have better clarity and focus on group template, let me remove the code snippet of the properties item template, header template, and footer template. Now, I have planned to group the employees according to their countries. For that, first I need to replace the existing data source with employee.json data source, which contains an array of objects with three fields, namely employee name, employee ID, and country. Then I will map these data source fields employee name and country to value and group by properties respectively. I'm going to display country names in bold and italic font. So let me define a variable autocomplete group template and add HTML elements bold and italic to it. And I also need to access the data source field country inside the HTML elements. Okay, now I will assign this variable autocomplete group template to group template property of autocomplete component. When you look at the autocomplete now, the data items are grouped under the category USA and England with bold and italic font. Okay, let me summarize some of the important points now. We have seen how to customize the view autocomplete items. Also, we have seen how to add header and footer for the autocomplete suggestion list and how to customize the autocomplete group title. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link which is shared in the description part below. If you find this video as useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching this video.